Maestro War and Pax number 2 of this 5 issues run was published 2 days ago with this impressive cover by Dale Keown, and continued with the interesting adventure of the Tyrant Hulk, known as the Maestro. After defeating all the rebels that would defy his absolute will, Maestro realized that his rule over Dystopia would not be enough, as he must destroy even the desire to dream, and as a result, created the new political movement named Post-Apocalyptic Existence, or PAX, and planned to unite humanity under a new world order. The old allies of the Hulk, known as the Pantheon, have been watching the Maestro, and they are not keen on his plans, and now they have been joined by Dr. Doom, who managed to find their secret base. Atlanta did not want to let him in, and told the team to ignore him, but Doom teleported himself inside the base. Hector foolishly tried to irritate Doom, who easily overpowered him and knocked him away. Atlanta then asked Doom how he is still alive, and Doom said that he is a time traveler and can go where and when he wishes to go, and his time machine transported him in there. Doom said that Maestro wants to conquer the world that Doom wants to live in. He will eventually consider Doom and the Pantheon as enemies, and he must be stopped. Atlanta said that Maestro possesses Banner's brain and Hulk strength, and that he is immortal, while the Pantheon are not. They live long, but they age and die. Destroying Dystopia is not an option, because this would waste the lives of the innocents, and they do not have any bomb that could stop the Maestro in the first place. Hulk might be invincible, but Banner is not. They suggested reverting the Hulk back to Banner and then take him down. Doom liked the plan and said that they only have to determine how to make it work. Later on in the Alchemax labs, the minister informed the Maestro that the Pantheon were waiting in the palace. The Maestro landed in the hole in a very unexpected way, making the Pantheon believe that he wanted to fight. Ajax knocked the Maestro away, remarking that he won't let him hurt anyone. Maestro said that he did not want to hurt anyone, before saying that he is Bruce Banner, the Hulk. Ajax, however, said that he looks different, and Hulk said, "'Cause it's been nearly a century." Maestro then invited the Pantheon to join him on the table, where he asked them about their new location. Atlanta then asked the Hulk about PAX, and Maestro explained that it means that everyone does what he tells them to do. Atlanta said that not everyone is going to like the PAX, such as the AIM, and asked if Hulk heard of them. Hulk said that they are the reason why he is there in the first place, as their leader named MODOK put the Hulk in hypersleep and kept him contained in their underground headquarters. Atlanta then said that they have to take AIM off the map, as they killed the Pantheon's member named Prometheus, and the Pantheon want the payback, but they have no idea where their headquarters is. Maestro then offered to show them the way to the AIM base, and they all went on the Pantheon's plane, which took off. On board, Maestro asked how Prometheus died, and Atlanta said that she does not like to talk about it. Maestro asked the simple-minded Ajax about Prometheus' death, and Ajax said that he got sick and died, and that no one killed him as Atlanta claimed. Maestro realized that the Pantheon were trying to fool him and grabbed Atlanta from the neck, demanding to know the truth or that she will die. Ulysses said that they do not need to fight the Maestro, and that he was going to drop Atlanta on his own. Suddenly, Maestro became paralyzed and could not even speak. Ulysses explained that the cabin is full of high-powered knockout gas, which could take out a herd of blue whales. The Pantheon, however, are wearing nose filters so that they won't be affected. Maestro then collapsed and lost his consciousness. Dr. Doom's hologram then appeared and said that his knockout gas did the trick, with Atlanta saying that phase 1 is complete and now it's time for phase 2. Peter David has been extremely depowering the Maestro, in my opinion. First, Hercules easily overpowered the Maestro, which never happened in the 616 reality, and now a knockout gas put him to sleep. Although the Hulk is known for his incredible durability and his ability to hold his breath for long periods of time. Let me know what you think about this run so far, and don't forget to subscribe and like. Thanks for watching and have a nice one.